today. I just mixed this with a little bit of that and this picture that I found from Google, and then you get this. Some type of blue humanoid thing. So feel free to name me, give this character some type of personality, and tons of virtual points to whoever gives me a backstory, and whichever one I love the most, the one that I feel in my little alien soul, I will be shouting you out in a future video. I know you guys are creative as heck. You guys have sent me so many drawings that you guys have done in my human form. Now I wanna see if you guys can give me a little bit of a personality. Just make sure to work in the muscles. Okay, so the reason why I wanted to be something not of this world is because the girl's post that we're talking about today is not of this world either. They are just so out there that they made me into this. I just turned into an alien. I did not want to be part of the earth anymore. So I'm no longer an earthling. I am whatever you guys are going to name my species. And I feel sorry for some of you guys because you guys are still earthlings, but that's not my problem anymore. I am smooth sailing in another galaxy. All I have to do is tell you about it. So let's do this. Hi guys, welcome to my channel, and if you are new here, I am a cosplayer, personal trainer, and of course a mommy to a very cute, adorable, smart baby alien pug. Welcome to my series Responding to Fat Chicks, where we find content from fat positive influencers and respond to them in a very civil way without having to attack their looks or physical features at all. We strictly talk about the content. You should know I am a past binger. I am a food addict that never goes away. I love food. It's a struggle every day not to go back to what I used to be. I was on the road to becoming morbidly obese like the majority of my family members. Like I've said in my past videos, they are so big that they will break furniture. So I can relate to a lot of these fat positive influencers in a sense, but at the same time, I am a personal trainer now. I did go through the process of figuring out how to live a healthy lifestyle and still have my treats on the side occasionally. I have been there where I thought that I was meant to just look like all of my family members. I am someone who thought that I would have to starve myself to be able to lose weight. I always thought that I was someone who had to work out for 3 to 4 hours to lose weight, and none of those are true once I finally figured it out. So I have gone through that process of what it takes to get to what I am today, a buff alien. So when I see those things, I would like to tell people at least what I did or what I've helped other people do to get over that hurdle. Now, usually I am very understanding in these videos. I understand that these are still people, and I make these videos as if I am responding to a client who is going through these issues. I try to be very sensitive, very professional as much as I can, being dressed up and being painted blue. But with that being said, I personally am not very fond of the influencer that I'm talking about today, and I will tell you why near the end of the video once we get through some of her content. So without further ado, we are talking about Virgie Tovar. Virgie Tovar, according to her Instagram bio, she's a creator, hashtag lose hate, not weight, author of You Have the Right to Remain Fat, contributor to At Forbes Women and At Bedsider, lives in San Francisco. She's got articles on Bedsider, and one of her articles are called Why Do People Have So Many Opinions About Boobs? And my opinion about boobs are that they are awesome and fun to play with. Womp womp, I'm up here. Up here. My alien face is up here. I know you were looking at my boobs. I'm just kidding. My boobs are really not out to play today. We are very family friendly today and appropriate. So if you still don't know who Virgie Tovar is, if you are someone who watches YouTube a lot, you probably know her from her most popular video, Take the Cake. No, I won't cut you a smaller piece. That's really what she called it, and there's no pun or joke in there. That's really what she's complaining about. Cutting a smaller piece of cake. In the video, Virgie explains that asking for a smaller piece of cake is a CRFI. Virgie, how about you tell the audience what that means?
A cake-related fatphobic incident, or CRFI.
A cake-related fatphobic incident. So through the whole video, Virgie and her other fat positive friends mock other women who want a smaller piece of cake.
That their slice is too large, and that the person who's cutting the cake, almost invariably a woman, must do some disproportionate amount of labor in order to accommodate their need to feel superior. Let's take a look.
Can you do a little bit, just like, can you like scrape all the frosting off and cut it in half and give me 2 forks because I'm sharing? Small, like a little bit more, like tiny, no. Like
they come up with all these instances that don't happen when people cut cake.
Cut my piece into 12 equal symmetrical little pieces and put each one into a tiny little Tupperware so that I can have a bite for each month of 2018.
And they act like cutting a smaller piece of cake is a, hold on, let me read exactly what it said, disproportionate amount of work in order to accommodate to the other person's needs. So Virgie considers herself a feminist. She talks a lot about patriarchy and how dieting holds women back, and a diet is the man trying to control us women on how we should look. So the video is very old. I don't need to react to it. A ton of other YouTubers have already done that. They made fun of it, literally dragged it through the galaxy, dropped it back to Earth, and did it again. And I'm guessing that's why comments were turned off. So basically, Virgie Tovar is a fat feminist who is fat positive, who says we should all accept who we are. All bodies are beautiful, women should do whatever they want with their bodies, and then calls women fat phobic for asking for a smaller piece of cake because they don't want diabetes. All while saying women should be free to do whatever they want. Are you confused? Because I am so confused at this whole thing. So instead of responding to an overly responded to video, we are going to be looking at Virgie's other content because she has a whole series going with the original video, Just Take the Cake. So today I wanted to look at Take the Cake, 20 Ways to Be Fat Positive, No Matter What Size You Are. So before we jump right into 20 Ways to Be Fat Positive, let's do my absolute favorite thing besides dressing up and look at some of her Instagram posts.
Diets aren't about portion control, they're about mind control. Diets are not innocuous tools of self-improvement. Diets have deep roots in some of the most troubling impulses in our culture's history, not least of which, the desire to control and capitalize on our precious spirits, bodies, and minds. Your limited mental real estate cannot be squandered on this shit.
So she's basically saying that diets control your mind. Diets are this underlining thing that men have thought up to control us women on what we eat and how we look. So that us women fit in this precious little box that men have created and deem what is acceptable to look at and what's desirable to be a woman. And I totally get that there are certain standards that the media holds women to be. They make us feel bad if we have cellulite or like a pudgy stomach or like a little bit of tricep fat or something. I get that, and especially in the age of Instagram, there's a lot of unrealistic body expectations going on. But she also gives me the vibe that a lot of other fat influencers give me, that they expect men to find them beautiful. And I think they forget that people have their preferences, and I think they also forget that out there somewhere, somebody is going to find you ugly.
You ugly. You your daddy's son, eh?
I get tons of comments calling me hideous. Thank you for those. That's mean, but at the same time, that's life. You can't be attractive to everybody, and you can't force people to find you attractive. And I find that more people are not going to find you attractive if you're forcing them to find you attractive. That's like the least attractive thing to do, and you'll see what I'm talking about once we get into more of Virgie's content. Okay, so first of all, at Tara Lynn is adorable and jiggly, and I love how much she's into talking about being nude all the time. So I just wanted to read the first part because I want to make a little bit of a point. There's nothing against the girl. She's beautiful. I think it's amazing that the company is creating bigger sizes for people, because last time I checked, bigger people need clothes too. Big plus if they're cute, because I don't know about you guys, if I have a cute outfit, I just feel better about myself. So nothing against that at all. That's awesome. But when they mention jiggling, it's just so interesting to me because a lot of these fat positive people are very obsessed with jiggle. I get what they're saying. Once again, I was a bigger girl, and I remember being very young, and this is when I wasn't even fat. I hit puberty early. I was a curvy chick at 10. I had boobs, but everything was coming in, and so all my girlfriends were like this, and then I was like this, and so you feel out of place. And I remember for some reason my friends who were already very thin were complaining about their thighs jiggling. But how do you think I felt about my thunder thighs? Not amazing. Actually pretty depressed and pissed at my genetics. Did it stop me from eating? Not at all. I was still gonna eat all the skin off of the KFC chicken and dip my hot Cheetos in nacho cheese. Yeah. Those were some dark days. But I just remember a lot of girls were very insecure about jiggling. So I get what they're doing. They're trying to be like, oh, see, like, everything jiggles. You're supposed to jiggle. But you are. It's very normal to have some movement on your body. You guys think that my thighs are legs of steel. My thighs jiggle. My butt most definitely jiggles because that's where I hold a lot of my body fat. But the people from the fat positive community take it to a whole nother level. A level and a thought process that is just out of your world. If you walk and your whole body has a ripple effect and is moving all over the place, that's a sign, even for thin girls who happen to have high body fat, aka skinny fat, that's a sign of lack of muscle, which is going to get worse when you get older, which can lead to some other problems. And obviously, jiggling to that degree means an unhealthy amount of body fat. I can see what they're doing. I'm fat, I'm jiggling, I'm embracing it, I'm showing you what my body can do and what it is natural for it to do. It's not very natural for it to do it, but I get what they're saying. They glamorize something that is so unhealthy, like it's right in their face. Their body is physically showing them that this situation is bad and it's only getting worse, and they just ignore it and they do this. Also, it's a fetish for some human men. We've talked about this in depth before on my channel. There are human men who are obsessed with obese women. The bigger and more immobile they are, the more attracted they are to them. They feed them, they pay them money to jiggle in front of cameras, and just be sedentary for the most part. And many of these fat positive influencers partake in this type of work. All while telling you how horrible men are, and patriarchy this, patriarchy that. Don't have men tell you what to do, and these dudes tell them to jiggle. I'm not saying Virgie does it, but many people from the fat positive influence group do that. So whenever they mention jiggle, I'm like, are you a cam girl? Because you just might be. Like I said, I have a couple overweight friends that are, they're not like morbidly obese, but they're thicker. They've got some jiggle around their stomach, and they say that that's like the number one requested thing, and you're gonna get more money if you just jiggle around a little bit. So since we're talking about jiggling, Virgie also has a camp where they jiggle a lot. It's in the description. And the camp is called Camp Thunder Thighs. I truly believe in the transformative power of radical self-love, political education, community building, and jiggling before breakfast. I also believe in the power of loving the body you are in right now. Nothing against that, I love that. You should love your body, because I don't think that you can just be like, hey, I think I'll take another body, just a different body. So I agree with that small little sentence right there. Others include smashing patriarchy, eating fancy desserts, and helping to build a world where every single person, regardless of size or health status, lives a life free from discrimination and bigotry. This weekend intensive is about supporting you, building community with you, and eating a lot of marshmallows on the beach near many majestic redwood trees. Together, we will break up with diet culture and the mindset that keeps us in restriction mode. So basically, you go to a camp with a bunch of other people who are probably very insecure, and she's going to tell you that it's okay that you are obese, and she's gonna feed you marshmallows and then tell you to jiggle around. So let's see how much this is gonna cost us, because I'm pretty sure we are all very interested. $689. $689. Dollars. Not alien dollars, if you're confused. 689 US human dollars to jiggle on the beach and eat marshmallows. They profit very well off of this fat positivity. They took something that is very easy to do. They tell people to not care about their body. You're fine the way you are. Don't worry about your health, because there's such thing as health at every size. Yeah. And just jiggle on the beach, eat marshmallows. Don't cut smaller pieces of cake, because you fat phobic piece of, and make sure to force your friends, family, acquaintances, work partners, anybody that's on your social media, and just the general public to think that you're attractive and tell you that you're healthy. They literally profit off of their followers' lack of health and future death. It's actually pretty sad, and like I said, I'm really not a fan of Virgie Tovar, because there's a few influencers that has hopped onto this body positive bandwagon who I really feel they think that they are meant to be this big. They really just don't understand what it takes to be healthy, and they don't understand that you can do, you know, slight little changes. You don't have to do anything drastic to bring your body fat down to a reasonable percentage. I think the elite people, or like the top people who get quite a bit of a following, like Tess Holliday, Virgie Tovar, and a bunch of other people who profit quite a bit of money, a lot of money, off of their followers, they know exactly what they're doing. She knows that she's fat. She knows it's unhealthy, but she doesn't give a f- because she's lazy and she found a niche that she can now profit off of because her followers are easily impressionable people who are not educated in fitness and health and they want the easy way out. And easy is so very easy to sell to people. She knows this and she profits off of it. It's actually very sick, and Tess Holliday knows this and Virgie Tovar knows this, and all they care about is money. They know damn well what they're doing. In fact, my alien senses are tingling and I am analyzing Virgie Tovar's mind, and yep, I was right, she doesn't care. She does not give a poop if her followers feel comfortable in their skin or if they feel free jiggling around on the beach or if they feel amazing. I mean, that's been proven many times how they react when someone in the body positive community loses weight and they say they feel better. Do you know what happens when that happens? They freak out, the person gets exiled because they feel better by losing weight.
And I pass it now. Exile.
Why? Because they are not going to profit off of somebody losing weight. All right, so let's read her 20 ways to be fat positive. 10 fat positive methods I love to suggest to non-fat people. Okay, non-fat people, if that's you, raise your hand. I really want you guys to listen because we are now gonna learn how to be fat positive. 1, recognize when your fat friends are killing it with their outfits, their professional life, or their crafting skills. Take a second to internally and silently recognize they're thriving against a lot of odds. Tell them they're killing it. Okay, so only the fat friend. Anybody who's overweight, obese, morbidly obese, you're killing it. No matter what you do, you're killing it. If you're just sitting there doing nothing about your weight, you're killing it. In all seriousness though, I tell anybody who is doing something positive that they're killing it. If you are working really hard and really trying to lose weight or just be positive, be better in your job, I always try to tell any of my friends, anyone that I'm talking to, that they are doing a good thing. Great job, you're killing it. But it sounds like she just wants her audience to just compliment fat people just because. Doesn't matter what they're doing, just compliment them. And that's not how it works. If you do something cool, something great, something amazing, you get complimented. If you do something like complain about cutting a smaller piece because it's too hard and too much work, then people are going to talk probably very badly about you. They are not going to compliment something like that. They are going to question your work ethic because it seems like you have none. Speak out against weight challenges at work, or maybe just don't do them. I think encouraging your employees to be healthier is great. I do have my own opinions about challenges because I think it makes people go into this survival mode. But one of the reasons why I stopped doing my challenges is because I noticed a lot of people were doing some odd things to try to lose weight fast so that they could win. When it's not about winning, it's about just being healthier. That's it, calm down. So I do agree with the whole challenge thing, but don't police your office. You in no way are being forced to do a diet challenge. 3, change your industry standard, especially if you're in medical care, fashion, or beauty. 4, pay for your fat friend's coffee. If you benefit from the wage gap between fat people and thin people. A lot of these things just sound like handouts. I don't wanna talk about a wage gap. A lot of these things we can make like smaller videos about, but being overweight or obese or morbidly obese is something that people can't control. Most people, like I said in a lot of my other videos, there's a very tiny percent that can't control it. They're on some kind of medication or something's going on. Tiny percent, most people are just overeating. So if there is a wage gap between thinner people and obese people, all you have to do is eat less, be more active, and stay consistent. And then it will be solved as long as you can stick to it. If you don't want to stick to that, then you have to deal with having less money. And you cannot expect people to pay for you for something that you yourself can fix. So now when we hit 5 is when we really hit some stuff that's just weird. Date and have sex with fat people. She doesn't go on to say like if you're attracted to them or whatnot. She just says do it. Date a fat person, have sex with one. Like I said before, they just expect people to give them the handouts, pay for their coffee. They expect people to just date them just for the pure fact that they're fat. Buy fat positive books, you know, so that they can continue to play with your brain and make you think the way that they think. Actively refuse to engage in food surveillance or food shaming behavior. So like when someone says, I want a smaller piece of cake, refuse to engage with their food shaming behavior because someone else eating a smaller piece of cake is gonna really ruin your day. I'd be like, great, more cake for me. Cake? You guys don't understand how much I love cake. Boycott and think critically about movies that promote bigoted representations of fat people. Yes, the ones with fat suits, but also movies that make fun of fat people or consistently portray fat people as asexual or unintelligent. So Endgame's out, Thor's out, all of it's out. Fat people can't be funny, and you can also not make fat jokes, but you can still make skinny jokes, muscular jokes, average people jokes. Those are all fine, but no fat jokes. Perfect. Got it. Support fat-owned businesses. So support you, Virgie. That's basically what she's saying. She's fat, she likes money, and so we need to support her and buy her books or buy her coffee. Call or check online to see if a restaurant, bar, or a theater has accessible seating before you hang out with your fat friend or date. I think that's very nice. I think that's a very sweet thing to do if you know you have a very large friend so that you make the environment very sweet for them. But at the same time, that's not their job. It's not my job. It's nobody's job but yours. You check them on the place because that's your butt cheeks. That's your weight. It's your body. And it's your issue. If your friend wants to call in like that, then that's a very, very nice thing to do. But don't expect people to do that. Entitlement. You guys know that really triggers me. Okay, so now we have 10 fat positive methods I love to suggest to other fat people. Okay, my overweight, obese, and morbidly obese people, it's time for you to listen up. This one's for you. Date and have sex with fat people. Do it. Take the time to recuperate negative self-attitudes. Okay, I can stand by that one. I like when people are a lot more positive. I think there are many people, skinny, average, muscular, overweight, obese, all the type bodies going on are very negative to themselves. I don't think there's anything wrong with loving your body, being confident, and changing it at the same time in order to become healthy. I think her point though is saying, you know, if there is someone that's fat, if you think negatively about your health, throw that out the window. Don't you get it, girl? There's health at every size. Don't worry about health. Hang out with other fat people a lot. Celebrate your fat body by spending time doing pleasure-based movements or self-massage. Masturbation, or I think that's what she's saying. Don't take from your doctors. You know your body best. That's right, people. If your doctor tells you you're at the end stages of diabetes and they're probably going to have to amputate a limb if you stay on the same route that you've been on, don't listen to them. They don't know your body. You do. Don't deprive yourself. Your body needs all of that food. Set boundaries and take no fat-phobic shit. What does that mean, though? They never say what fat-phobic is. Come in.
One's for you and one's for Garrett.
Aww! So she got me happy birthday cupcakes, which I will eat. One's for my boyfriend, but I'll probably eat that one too. Watch porn that features people as close as possible to your body type. 8, stop dieting. Ha! Well, because I now have 2 Suzy cakes that I will eat all for myself. Create loving representations of fat people. 10, understand that you do not benefit from engaging in fat phobia.
Not even a little.
Basically, you don't benefit from health talk. Talking about health doesn't benefit you at all. It's just gonna hurt your feelings, so ignore it. So there you go. I'm honestly pretty happy that I am in a different galaxy. Sorry if I seem a little agitated in this video, but I just don't respect what she's doing. But anyway, if you guys have any other influencers, videos, posts that you guys want me to react to, just tell me in the comment section. I read all of my comments and there's always a chance that your suggestion will end up in a video. So don't be shy. I'm pretty sure most of my species love earthlings. I mean, as long as you hit that subscribe button. As long as you hit that button at the bottom of the screen that says subscribe, I will not obliterate your world. I don't know. I'm still trying to figure out me. It's up to you guys to tell me what she is. Also, I want to say thank you for 80K. You guys, best birthday present ever. We are almost to my goal to 100K, and I am so excited and so grateful for all of you, all the new people, all the people that have been with me forever. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Remember, you do not have to be a size 2. Abs are great to have, but they are not needed to be healthy. But health is very important, and I want all my watchers, even the ones that hate me, even the Virgie Tovar fans that are going to call me some weird alien freak in the comment section, to be healthy as well. Thank you for watching. I will see you in another video in another outfit. Bye, guys.